last class?
Yes, sir. He was there.
Okay. So you all can switch on your cameras, okay?
So good morning.
Good morning.
Okay. So in last class, we have discussed about sorting. Okay. We have completed searching and we were doing sorting. In sorting, I have done one program in which we were arranging the height of the student, and I have given you another program in which we have to arrange the height of a student with their corresponding weights also. So how many of you were able to complete the program? Kis kis ne program sahi se complete kar liya hai? Because I have seen a solution of only few. Okay, everyone has not sent me the solution. So who else was able to complete it ya kisi se nahi hua? Just let me know, then I'll solve it again for you, beta.
So mujhse nahi hua.
So
okay.
I wasn't able to solve.
Okay. So I'll discuss that program and we'll do one more program today. Okay. That program was totally, I told you, we have to arrange the height in ascending order. Height of all the students, number of students that will be entered by user, we have to arrange that height in ascending order. And their corresponding weight will also be arranged. That means weights, it is not mandatory that weights will be there in ascending or descending order, but it will be corresponding. Ho sakta hai jiski height sabse kam ho, uska weight sabse zyada ho. Theek hai? So that doesn't matter. We have to just arrange the weight according to the height. Okay. So I'll start just after the scanner line. As you all know the opening lines. Theek hai? In this question, I was not knowing the size of array. That means I was not knowing the data for how many students we have to solve it. So I'll ask from user first of all, system.out.println, enter the number of students. Am I correct? We were told that we have to ask the number of students from user.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So enter the number of students. Suppose I have taken this as n, int n equals to sc dot next int. So that means number of students I have stored in variable n. Is it visible, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now when I am having the size, then only I will be able to create my array. Abhi tak size nahi tha, so we could not create the array. Now I am having the size, so I will create the array. Suppose first array I am creating for height. So I have taken name as ht and data type as double ht equals to new double and size is n. Any doubt in this step, beta?
No, sir.
Okay, I have created an array called ht. It is for height. Data type is double because heights can be in decimals also. New double and size is n. You all know the syntax of creating array. Total number of students n the, that's why we have kept sizes n. Okay, now we have to create another array that is for weight. So I have taken it as wt. So double wt equals to new double and the size is again n. Because number of students in ki height of the unique weight bhi honge. So the size is n. So now I've created two arrays. We have got the size also. Now what I need to do? I need to enter the data. I need to enter the values. Humko iske andar values enter karani hai. So how will get it enter? Just display a message to user. Enter the height. Now see what I'll do. I'll write a single message. I'll ask both the values in single message. Main dono values ek hi message mein maang leta hu. Theek hai? Enter the height and weight of a student. Now what I did? I displayed the message, enter the height and weight of a student. Ab isse kya hoga? यूजर जिस स्टूडेंट की हाइट एंटर करेगा उसी का वेट भी एंटर कर देगा. दैट मींस कोई फॉल्स वैल्यूज नहीं आएंगी, कोई डिफरेंट वैल्यूज नहीं आएंगी, रैंडम वैल्यूज नहीं आएंगी. कोरिस्पॉन्डिंग हाइट एंड वेट विल बी एंटर्ड. अब इसके बाद क्या करते हैं, व्हाट वी डू, वी जस्ट अप्लाई द फॉर लूप. इंट आई इक्वल्स टू जीरो, आई लेस देन एन एंड आई प्लस प्लस. दिस इज द रिक्वायर्ड फॉर लूप विच वी अप्लाई. नाउ आफ्टर दिस विल स्टोर द वैल्यूज. एच टी फर्स्ट आई आस्क फॉर हाइट, सो फर्स्ट वैल्यू विल बी स्टोर्ड इन हाइट. एच टी आई इक्वल्स टू एस सी डॉट नेक्स्ट, sc dot next double, and then corresponding weight will also be entered. So weight will be stored in wti equals to sc dot next double. So like this I will get input in my array. Now any doubt till now? यहाँ तक किसी को कोई भी doubt बेटा?
No sir.
To all our training class, Avi, Arnesh, Ananya, Adarshita, Akshay, Kushal and Smriti. Asim is absent.
Okay. So right now I think it is clear to everyone. If you want to note it down, better note it down, because I need to rub it and then I'll write again. So, if you want to note it down till here. And nobody will use this shortcut. I'm using, but you will not use. Okay. You'll write the full forms. Meanwhile, you can leave this space and afterward you can complete it. Adarshita?
Yes, sir.
Adarshita? Beta, are you having any doubt? Because you have not attended last class. Yes, Adarshita? Yes,
sir. No, sir. Pakka, I'm not having any doubt.
Is it clear, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Kushal, note it down, beta. Akshay? Akshay?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear to you? अभी तक जितना लिखा है क्लियर है अक्षय? You were also absent in last
class. Yes, sir. Note भी कर रहा हूँ.
Okay.
Sir, last class में absent था मैं.
Yes, you were absent.
Okay.
डन बेटा.
सर लास्ट टू लाइंस.
ओके ओके, नोट इट डाउन. Done?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
All of you?
Yes, sir. Sir, बस आखिरी का थोड़ा सा नोट. Sir, done.
Okay. All of you done, beta?
I'm going to erase it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So till now we have done input in our array. So we have taken all the values as input for height and weight. Now we'll perform the sorting part. And sorting was supposed to be done on height. Heights को हमें sort करना था and उसी के according weight को भी display करना था. So how sorting is done? Those who have attended classes, they know how sorting will be done.
Sir.
Yes, beta.
Sir, I can't see you.
Now am I visible?
Yes, sir.
Int I equals to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus. For int j equals to 1, j is less than n minus I, j plus plus. N minus 1 minus I. If st j is greater than st j minus 1,
see beta, in the starting we forgot to take two variables, just initialize them in that step, int temp and temp1, where we have declared the arrays na, just after arrays declare two variables, int temp and temp1, just declare it bit over there. Now see, is it visible, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see, yes. Now this is the complete logic of sorting, which we all know. First loop, this loop is for the passes which are going on in our loop, and this is for bubbles. The two values which we are taking, okay? What we are doing, now we are comparing both of them. As you can see, we have compared the second element with the first element, ठीक है? That means पीछे वाले element को the later element with the former element. We are comparing पीछे वाले element with the आगे वाला element. If we are finding that the last element is greater, तो उसको हम लोग आगे लेके आ रहे हैं. If the last element is smaller, तो उसको हम लोग आगे लेके आ रहे हैं. Because we are arranging heights in ascending order. पीछे वाला एलिमेंट अगर छोटा है तो उसको हम आगे लेके आते हैं. तो हाउ वी आर ब्रिंगिंग इट, वी आर डूइंग स्वैपिंग. नाउ सी, दिस वी आर डूइंग स्वैपिंग इन हाइट, दिस वी आर डूइंग स्वैपिंग इन हाइट, दिस वी आर डूइंग स्वैपिंग इन हाइट, एंड कोरिस्पोंडिंगली वी आर स्वैपिंग इन वेट्स ऑल्सो. एज यू कैन सी, हम लोग हाइट को स्वैप कर रहे हैं लाइक वी यूज टू डू अर्लियर. फर्स्ट सेकेंड वैल्यू स्टोर्ड इन टेम, then first value is stored in second value, and then temp value is stored in first value. Similarly, we are doing for weight array also. As you can see, these sticks are for height and these arrows are for weight. So we are doing simultaneously. हम लोग साथ ही साथ दोनों values को swap कर रहे हैं, दोनों arrays को swap कर रहे हैं. That's why we'll be able to arrange both the values corresponding. अगर height में चौथे बच्चे की height पहुंच गई पहले number पे, तो चौथे बच्चे का weight will be also be shifted to the first place. By this way we can do it. Otherwise, हमको फिर बाद में weight को sort करने में problem होगी. Corresponding weights को arrange करने में we'll face problem.
सो दैट्स व्हाई वी आर डूइंग इट साइमल्टेनियसली. हम लोग उसी टाइम पे जैसे हमने हाइट को शिफ्ट किया उसी के वेट को भी शिफ्ट कर दिया तुरंत. उससे क्या होगा एट द एंड हमारी एरे कोरिस्पोंडिंगली पूरी तरीके से सेट रहेगी. इज इट क्लियर बेटा?
यस सर.
यस सर.
एनी डाउट टू एनीवन?
नो सर.
ठीक है, तो जस्ट नोट इट डाउन. आफ्टर दिस वी विल डू द डिस्प्ले पार्ट. स्मृति इज इट विजिबल बेटा?
यस सर.
ओके. Some of you cameras is off. I guess Smriti ka camera off hai. Adarshita's camera is off. Akshay.
So done.
Okay. Now let me tell you, beta, for your half yearlies, your syllabus will be chapter number 1, that is revision of class 9. Yes. Chapter number 2, classes as an object, matlab, that is most of covered in class 9th only. Okay? And chapter number 6, that is arrays. Okay? So today we'll finish with this chapter. We'll completely finish with this chapter. We have done output questions also. We have done varieties of program also, which can come. Okay? After this chapter, we'll start with the strings, beta. We'll start with the strings. So when we finish the string, we'll come back to array and we'll do 2-3 more programs of array which are based on strings. Array ke kuch programs string pe based hain. As we all know, jab se humne Java padhna start kiya, all the things which we are studying, they get merged. Sab kuch club ho sakta hai ek dusre mein. So that's why when we'll complete the string also, we'll come back to array. Aur tab hum log uska thoda sa देखेंगे हाउ एरे प्रोग्राम कैन ऑल्सो बी मर्ज विद स्ट्रिंग. ठीक है, बट दैट मर्जिंग पार्ट विल नॉट कम इन योर हाफ एरेज, इट विल कम इन योर कंपेरेटिव्स. सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. टिल नाउ व्हाट आई विल टीच दैट विल बी योर फाइनल सिलेबस फॉर हाफ एरेली. ठीक है, टुडे इज द लास्ट क्लास फॉर योर हाफ एरेली सिलेबस. इन नेक्स्ट क्लास आई विल कंडक्ट टेस्ट फॉर दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज टुमारो वी विल हैव टेस्ट फॉर दिस चैप्टर, रिविजन टेस्ट, एंड देन फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट वीक वी विल स्टार्ट विद स्ट्रिंग्स. And again, before the half yearlies, we'll conduct our proper revision test for complete syllabus. Is it fine, Buddha?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Done. Have you noted this?
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. Should I erase it?
Yes, sir.
Akshay, done.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we have done input part, we have done the logic part. Now what is left? Now what is left? Class 10, what is left?
The display part.
Display part. So we have to display complete height array in ascending order and their corresponding weight also. Okay. So let's display the message system.out.println heights in ascending order is, apply the loop I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus SOP HTI plus is it fine? Heights in ascending order is all the heights will be displayed. Okay, I have applied SOP, so all the data will be displayed in a single line with differentiated by comma. Now with the height we have to display weight also, so we'll display weight. Or see, we can do one more thing, beta. we can display height and weight like this also. Like suppose height and then weight. We can display it like this also. In a row column method. एक तरफ सारी height हो गई ascending order में and nearly उनका corresponding weight हो गया. So let's do in this way. ठीक है, in this way we'll display तो heights और weight corresponding हमको दिखेंगे भी. In this way it will be in vertical line, sorry horizontal line, and in this form it will be in vertical line. So let's follow the vertical line rule. ठीक है, because this is easy, you all can do. This displaying is easy ना बेटा, everyone can do I guess. So let's go for this vertical form. Okay. SOP LN height plus / T plus weight. See, this will be my heading. Height / T weight. Why I put / T? What is the use of / T, beta?
Sir, to put the space equal to tab.
Huh, to put the space equals to tab. So height will be written here and weight will be written here as a heading. Now let's display the value. First of all, we'll apply the for loop. Int I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. SOP HTI plus / T plus WTI. Now with this height, under the heading height, first height will be displayed, that is sorted height, and under the heading weight, its corresponding weight will be displayed. But this is SOP, okay? And we need another value at bottom. So what we'll do, we'll put a blank SOP LN over here. हम यहाँ पे खाली SOP LN लगा देंगे. So what it will do, first value will be displayed and then line will be changed. Then again second value will be displayed and line will be changed and so on. All the data will be displayed in different lines. So here our display part gets over, the main gets over, the class gets over. So finally the program is complete for displaying the data. Now any doubt in display part, beta? Any doubt to anyone?
No sir.
Is it clear?
Yes sir.
So just finish it, then I'll give you another program.
Excuse me sir. Sir, why can't we put SOP LN in the line where it is written SOP HT at I plus / T?
Here also, na?
Yes, sir.
We can put beta. We can write SOP LN over here also. Actually, I told you this because we were displaying single array with SOP. हम लोग भी तो array SOP के साथ display कर रहे थे ना? That's why I told you if you have written SOP, you can write SOP LN over here. So it will change the line. Otherwise, you can write SOP LN here also. This can be SOP LN, then we don't need to write this line. To store height of n students.
Yes, sir.
Arnesh, what will be the next variable, beta?
Sir.
Yes, Arnesh, what will be the next variable?
Sir.
Others, please mute. Sir. Arnesh.
Yes, sir.
What will be the next variable?
Sir, just a minute.
Smriti, just wait, beta. Let him answer first. Anish, you were not attending the class properly.
Sir, I am.
Then? Akshay? Akshay has left. Smriti, what will be the next variable? Smriti, what will be the next variable, beta?
Sir, I.
I. Okay. Data type?
Sir, int.
Int. Description?
Sir, display the looping counter.
Looping counter. So description will be looping counter. Adarshita? Adarshita?
Yes, sir.
Next variable.
Sir, now.
After I, what was the variable we have taken?
Again. Sir, J. Yes, sir, so J was there.
J. What is the use? What is the use for J? Okay, I am telling you. J is basically, just note it down. It is used to compare two values of an array. It is used to compare two values of an array. With the help of J only, beta, we can pick two values and then we are able to compare. Form a bubble. So it is used to compare two values of an array. Okay, Avi. Yes. Next variable, beta.
The next variable is temp.
Temp. Data type of temp?
Sir, double.
Double. And description?
Sir, it is a temporary variable to swap the value of height.
Temporary variable to swap the values of array height. And similarly, temp one will also be there. Temporary variable to swap the values of weight. So total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven variables are there in this program. Okay. Just draw this VD table and then we'll start the new program. Just let me know when you are done, beta.
Sir, done.
What about others? Done, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now note down next program, beta. Write a program. Write a program to create an array. Write a program to create an array for number of students. Write a program to create an array for number of students entered by user. For number of students entered by user. Noted, beta?
Yes, sir.
Full stop. Enter their names. Enter their names and their marks. Enter their names and their marks in two different arrays. Enter their names and their marks in two different arrays, full stop, written?
Yes, sir.
Sir?
Huh? Yes, beta.
Two different arrays.
Full stop. Full stop. Display the name and marks of the highest. Display the name and marks of the highest score. And the lowest score. Display the name and marks of highest score and the lowest score. Written, beta?
Sir, please repeat.
Yes.
Display the name and marks of highest score and the lowest score.
Yes.
Noted, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, have you understood what we have to do in this program? Kya karna humko is question mein?
Yes, sir.
What we have to do? Just tell me which technique we will apply to achieve this, the highest and the lowest marks. Which technique we should apply?
Sir, bubble sort.
Bubble sort, okay. Adarshita, what do you feel? Will we be able to get our required data by applying bubble sort?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Why from bubble sort? Adarshita, please explain me. Why from bubble sort?
So, because because we have to find the student having the highest marks and the lowest marks.
Okay.
And
what happens by sorting? When we sort, what happens to our array? जब हम लोग सॉर्टिंग करते हैं तो हमारी एरे में क्या हो जाता है? यस आदर्शिता, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर योर आंसर. व्हाट हैपेंस इन आवर एरे व्हेन वी आर डूइंग सॉर्टिंग? स्मृति, डू यू वांट टू टेल? जब हम लोग सॉर्टिंग करते हैं तो हमारी एरे में क्या हो जाता है? Arnesh, you tell me the answer.
Sir.
जब sorting करते हैं तो array में क्या होता है?
Sir, sorting करते हैं तो array में मतलब ascending और या descending में जा.
Yes, array हमारी arrange हो जाती है either ascending और descending order में. And when we have data in an order, जब हमारे पास data एक ascending order में होता है, तो what we have, Adarshita? Smallest value will be at first position and largest value will be at the last position. Is it clear? And
yes, sir.
What I have to display? The highest marks and the lowest marks. So highest will be at the last and lowest will be at the first. So to achieve both values, we have to sort our array. Okay, now let's start this program. It is very much similar to the program which we have done right now. Height and weight wala jaise kiya na, total waisa hi hai. It is totally similar. What you have to do in starting, first of all, initialize the size, SOPLN, enter the number of students. But I just keep on copying with me, okay? Because I guess we have only 6 to 7 minutes left. Enter the number of students. I have stored the number of students in N. ठीक है, सो आई स्टोर द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स इन एन. नाउ लेट्स टेक एरे फॉर स्टोरिंग नेम. स्ट्रिंग नेम इक्वल्स टू न्यू स्ट्रिंग, साइज विल बी एन, एंड मार्क्स आर देयर. सपोज आई हैव टेकन मार्क्स इन डबल, डबल मार्क्स इक्वल्स टू new double n, double temp string temp 1. Okay. One array is for string, for storing name, another is of double, for storing marks. Similarly, one temp is for double and one temp 1 is for string, because we have to swap names also, we have to swap marks also. Is it clear, beta?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now we'll display the message SOPLN enter the name and marks of students. Enter the name and marks of students. We'll apply the for loop int I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. String I equals to sc dot next line marks I equals to sc dot next See, now any doubt till here, beta? Any doubt till here? We have created two arrays. We have taken two variables for swiping. Enter the name and marks. For loop is applied. Name, sc dot next line. Marks, sc dot next double. See, this was a string. A string array. That is why we have written the line for the string. This is double array. We have written the line for double. Is it clear, beta? Any doubt till here?
No, sir.
Okay, okay. Note it down quickly, beta. It is almost similar to the previous program which we have done.
It's not clear.
What is not clear, beta? Displays blur?
Yes, sir.
Just do one thing, leave and then again join the meeting, beta. It must be some internet issue. Other city is visible, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Quickly note.
Sir, I can't see six lines.
You can't see, beta, which line? This one?
Yes, sir.
Enter the name and marks of students.
Sir, uska upar wala.
String temp 1.
Thank you, sir.
Now, is it visible? I think we need to stop here only, beta. I'll continue this program tomorrow. Okay? Meanwhile, you can note it down, just complete it, and then you can end the session. Complete it, we'll continue this program tomorrow, and after completion, we'll take a quick test for this chapter, okay? I'll take a quick test, I'll give you two programs. You need to do it. 201 program that I'll see. I'll give you one program for 15 marks and some output questions, okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir, note
it. Yeah, just note it down till here because we are running short of time, beta. So we'll continue the remaining part of program tomorrow. For starting so 5 minutes, complete the program. Yes, beta?
Sir, programming so varies and the looping programming will be optional or not?
In exams, beta. In your half-yearly
examinations.
Yes, but you'll get choices, but not for array and those programs. you will get total of 6 programs in which you have to opt 4 programs. Now that depends on you which category of program you leave. Only 1 or 2 program will be there from array. Okay, those who have noted, beta, any doubt till now for this program or previous program? This program will complete it tomorrow. I'm asking about the previous program. Any doubt? Any doubt to everyone? Anyone, beta? So if it is clear, then we can end the session, beta, and we'll continue tomorrow. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay then, bye bye, take care, beta.
Bye sir,
thank you, sir.
Bye bye. You sir end karein.